everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside. We're about ready to go with another big week of championship wrestling. David.
All ready today with the Sheepherders in here for our opening tag team match of the day. Following that, got what should be a good match. Bill Superstar Dundee, Terry Taylor on one side of the ring. On the other, it'll be Bobby Eaton and Sweet Brown Sugar. They'll have Jimmy Hart with them. But that's not all. Then we've got an expiration of time match today. The Dynasty will be in here for that one. Jimmy Cornette will have Apocalypse and the exotic Adrian Street. All of that coming up today.
And I'll tell you one thing I'm looking forward to, and that is sharing with all of our championship wrestling fans, David, the entire episode of the World Heavyweight Championship match between Jerry Lawler and Nick Bockwinkel, and the most incredible unveiling of events that took place that I believe I have ever seen. All of that on this particular championship wrestling. You stay right where you are. We're going to be back and get at it in just a moment.
All 15-minute time limit match at a total weight of 415 pounds over on the right of the screen. From Memphis, Tennessee, Ira Reese, and from Tupelo, Mississippi, Ken Raper. Going against him, total weight of 471 pounds from New Zealand, Jonathan Boyd and Luke Williams, the Sheepherders. One fall, 15-minute time limit match. Jerry Calhoun is the referee.
Oh, yeah, we take a little time out right there to go through the flag ceremony that the Sheepherders always do on their New Zealand flag. We are ready. It's bell time and off and running. Luke Williams starting out against Ira Reese, and I don't envy Ira Reese and Ken Raper.
Absolutely. Reese and Raper are going against one of the most rugged tag teams ever to be in the area here in the Sheepherders. Luke Williams in there right now. Jonathan Boyd waiting out in the corner. Ira Reese dragged over by the corner. Tag is made, and the Sheepherders make a double team exchange. Williams hanging in there to hold him up while Boyd was letting him have it in the rib cage with the right hand. Jonathan Boyd, upper arm.
Southern Tag Champions, the Sheepherders. No title match today.
Jonathan Boyd punishing Ira Reese.
Boyd is always making these long dissertations about being manly and the men from down under and all of that. And I distinctly have the impression that the Sheepherders confuse manlyhood with brutality. That's just their style of wrestling, Dave, is just pure savage.
Yes, indeed. Williams backs to the ropes, drops down with the right hand, picks up Ira Reese, center of the ring, takes him over partway to the corner, jabbed him with a thumb in the throat. Williams makes the tag. Jonathan Boyd will be coming back in. The Ram. Minute and a half gone, 15-minute time limit match. Jonathan Boyd. Round behind Ira Reese.
You know, I think a lot of times you and I talk about having to undergo the harangues of the Sheepherders when they're over wanting to let the wrestling fans know about their great abilities and how manly they are. Think about the poor referee when he looks at the card and says, "Oh man, I got the Sheepherders today." Yeah.
Reversal by Ira Reese. He's over to the corner, makes a tag on Ken Raper. Williams after him before Raper can really get into the ring good. He nailed him from behind. Haymaker swing he put on the side of the head. Williams fires him across the ring. Ken Raper off the ropes, knee to the midsection. Williams over to the corner, makes the tag on the other Sheepherder, Jonathan Boyd. Upper arm by Boyd. And again.
And again, the referee has to get physical and start that count to get him away from double-teaming.
Boyd makes the tag on Williams, fires Raper into the ropes, and the two of them drop him to the mat. Williams does not go for the pin. He picks Raper up. Body slams him. Now Boyd picks him up on his shoulders. Yeah. Drop down. Williams with a cover. Count is one, two, and
that's
three.
All.
Easy victory for the Sheepherders in the non-title match here. 3 minutes, 8 seconds, the time on it. 3:08, and a win for the Sheepherders.
Yeah, it's kind of like the situation of putting 100 pounds of sand or something in the trunk of your car or the back of a station wagon to get better traction. They pick one or the other up and then just drop down with that additional 225 pounds or so. And look at it.
Going after
it
down here on the floor with that flagstaff and chair.
Get those guys out of here. Well, they ravaged Ira Reese and Ken Raper, not unexpected. That time again, Dave?
Time on it was 3:08.
3:08, and part of that was because they chose not to go for a pin earlier, and they just wanted to inflict a little additional punishment. We've said it before, but I want to see them do that kind of stuff to the great team of Stan Lane, Steve Kern, the fabulous ones. The result would not be the same. Let's take a look at this. Fabulous ones. We got more action coming up in just a moment. Oh, yeah, Tuesday night. Going to get right into it, my friend. Louisville Gardens is where it's going to be. 7 big championship wrestling matches paid off with, take a listen. You're going to have to stay tuned to the rest of the program to find out all about it. It'll be beautiful Bobby Eaton, Sabu, with Jimmy Hart at ringside, going against Jerry the King Lawler and his partner, Sweet Brown Sugar. Yeah, you heard it right. One less member of the family now.
Woo! Who is the smartest man in professional wrestling? Why am I? Jimmy Hart, baby. He who laughs last laughs the loudest. I took the world belt away from Lawler. I've got to even talk Kaufman into putting $5,000 up to anybody can put Lawler in the hospital. So, Coco Ware, it's going to be paint up, clean up, fix up week right there. I might bring a little paint and do a little painting, baby, on you. And I'm definitely going to do a little fixing on you. I promise you that. But it's going to be a super night. I can't wait. What about you, Bobby?
I can't wait neither. And I'll tell you one thing I do hate. Lance, that's crybabies and sissies. And Coco, why are you a crybaby? Because you're running around town crying and saying I lost the Southern Heavyweight belt for you. Coco, why are you just couldn't get the job done, son? You're not man enough. Now, I delivered a promise to Jimmy Hart. I said I'd win that Middle America belt, and I did. So, Coco, why are you couldn't do it? Like I said, you're not a man. You're crying. But I'm going to make you give a little respect to the first family that you didn't get when you was with us. We don't like losers. That's reason you're not with us right now. Now, you teaming up with a loser, Jerry Lawler. Now, Coco, when I get through with you, I'm going to let Mr. Lawler have just a little bit of Zabu, and when he gets about halfway down, Lawler, I'm going to come in and I'm going to beat the rest of you up, and I'm going to take the $5,000 off of
you. You're looking at the greatest team in the history of professional wrestling, Zabu and beautiful Bobby Eaton, baby. So, Coco, you can go back to Lawler. I taught him how to dress. I taught him how to talk. I've done it all for him. So you know what you're going to do? You are a follower, not a leader. You're going to be hanging around Lawler. Before it's over, you're going to be saying, yes, sir, Mr. Lawler, whatever you want. Yes, sir, King, whatever you want. I'll do it all, baby. It's over, baby, over. Come on, boys.
Tuesday night, Louisville Gardens. You're going to see it all happening in there. Stay tuned right now to see what put it out, and you'll see Jimmy Hart's boys, Bobby Eaton and Sabu, against Lawler and Sweet Brown Sugar. And a very active week of championship wrestling that has taken place around the United States and the world. One of the developments, Jimmy Hart and the First Family now are possessors of the Mid-America heavyweight title. And here they come, without all of the bandages and everything. Jimmy, this has got to be another one of those great days in the life of Jimmy Hart.
Well, you know what? That shows exactly how stupid and how you stand out here week after week making a fool out of yourself. It ain't a great day for me, baby. It's a great week for Jimmy Hart. It's probably been the greatest week of my life, man. Beautiful Bobby Eaton. Come here, get a shot of this, baby. Bobby Eaton won me that big Mid-America title here. Sabu won his. That Sugar did mess up just a little bit, baby. We won a little rain cloud, baby. That was all. But the family's coming back. Coming back stronger, baby. And I can't wait, Bobby. I love you.
Love you,
love you, baby.
I didn't
make
you
that. Man, look, don't even worry. Don't bother me out here with things like that. Don't be stupid out here, baby.
Jimmy's bubbling.
Before, this is going to be the greatest week of the First Family's life. I've got it all back. When you've been down as low as Jimmy Hart's been with a broken hand, a burnt face, they're calling it the greatest comeback in the history of professional wrestling today. The greatest comeback in the history of professional wrestling today. Bobby, I love you, baby.
Yep.
I love you, boy.
Bobby Eaton, of course, defeated Jacques Rougeau for the Mid-America
No sweat at all.
Belt.
No sweat at all, baby. No sweat at all.
I didn't lose the match.
The match that Sweet Brown Sugar is talking about was a Southern heavyweight title match that he had with Terry Taylor, and he was not able to defeat Taylor for the title. Taylor was able to keep his title, but
listen, that's
the future. I guess one out of two ain't bad.
The future, baby, is what's happening. The future is what's happening, and Jimmy Hart and the family, we've just begun, baby. We've just begun.
Wait, before you get into foreseeing the future for the First Family and all of that, let's talk about what did happen, because I happen to be right at ringside for the World Heavyweight Championship match.
Bobby the one calls me a loser, man.
Come on, you guys. Will you guys set? Hey, come on, Hart. Get these guys stopped. Now, get out here. Listen, you take it on your own. Do it on your own time, you guys. You guys want to argue about it, go somewhere else.
Shut up!
I want to talk to Jimmy Hart about what happened at the World Heavyweight Championship match. Come on, Hart. Quit that stuff.
And embarrass me in front of all these people.
You guys, come on.
Gee, that's
settle
Paul,
it down,
he's been whining
Bobby.
Like a woman
that's,
all week, man.
No excuse,
been whining like a woman.
Come on, Jimmy. I just Jimmy settle down.
Oh, you shut up. I'll run the family. I'm in charge of the family.
No,
I've got everything under control.
You don't have to
don't
do
even interrupt me.
Hey,
you just
like a woman.
Just go on back to the back. I don't want excuses. I want results.
You guys are results. You guys are going to stand out here and argue. All of you just go to the back. I want to talk to you about something else, and you stand out here acting like a bunch of kids on a schoolyard slapping around.
There's I've no got excuse. Everything under control.
Okay,
why don't you just
okay,
shut up and
fine.
Quit instigating everything
all right,
here? I'll run the family. I'll run the family.
In the World Heavyweight Championship match.
Well,
when,
like I was saying, when? Go ahead. When what?
When Nick Bockwinkel and Jerry the King Lawler got together to decide the title holder on it, and I must tell you that Jimmy Hart had a prominent role. Stay right where you are, because I want you to see the end of that match in the most incredible
charade that I'm going to show. Bless
your
heart, Russell. I'm going to give you a big kiss. We ought to give him a big kiss.
You're finally doing something.
Let's take a look at it. But Bockwinkel slips out of it, and Hart about to have a fit in the corner with Dundee right next to him. Billy grabbed his shoulder and held him down. Boy, double right hands, and Bockwinkel and Lawler, who were both through the vicious 10 minutes of it, both stunned. They hit the deck hard, and Lawler, and hard up out of the chair, gets away from Dundee. Dundee grabs him by the waist while Lawler turns Bockwinkel over. He's got him. But the referee trying to get Hart back from the ropes, and Lawler still got him covered. He can't get a pin. Lawler goes over and blasts Hart loose. What is this? Here is Jimmy Hart on here. Jerry Lawler, we are dumbfounded with Jimmy Hart with no mask. And Lawler was rolled up 1, 2, 3. And the winner is Nick Bockwinkel in 11:22. The world heavyweight title goes to him. I don't believe it. I can't understand it. What is this? Andy Kaufman under the guise.
Beautiful. Look at that, Russell. Come here, Andy. Come here. Come here, Andy. Come
we
here,
got the
baby.
Brains, baby. We got the brains.
What is this kind of a thing?
You he who laughs last laughs the loudest, baby.
Lawler, I got you. You thought you saw the last of me. I'll keep coming till you end up in the hospital.
And there they go.
Who is the
fleeing
man
for
in
their
professional
life?
Wrestling yeah. Where am I?
You are, Jimmy. You are, baby.
Can't Kaufman keep a job or something?
Oh, baby,
steady
you know, they're
on
just
television.
So stupid, hey, baby.
All he does
I picked
is
the little phone up and I called him and I yeah. said, hello, is Andy Kaufman there in Hollywood? And the people said, who's calling? And I said, Jimmy Hart. And she got him to the phone and I told him what I had in mind. And I said, Andy, I said, you're mad at Lawler. He almost put you out of your whole show business career. And he said, yeah, I'm mad. And I said, well, I'm mad too because he burnt my face. He tried to break my hand. He tried to do it all to me. But I said, let's don't be mad, baby. Let's just get even. Let's just get even, man. But you know what's so tragic about this thing? I just wish there was a couple people that could share this with me, Lawler. Your daddy and Sam Bass, baby, because I wish they were here with it, baby. Woo, because it is the greatest day of my life. The greatest day of my life, baby.
Will you just shut up a minute?
Hey, shut up. You shut up.
Don't ever tell me to shut up.
Right.
I'll slap you and send you to the back, baby.
We talked to Andy Kaufman and Jimmy Hart right after it was all over with, and take a listen to this.
You have no respect for him. Miami, look at this, man. Tell him, Jimmy.
I am in the locker room at the Mid-South Coliseum with Andy Kaufman and Jimmy, TV star Andy Kaufman. I will tell you right now, it is not my idea, but we are interested in finding out what led to the kind of charade that took place that deprived Lawler of the world. Oh, tell me it wasn't a charade. Everybody, you came out. Yeah, he lost it out there. Don't you have anything better to do than to run around trying to gig Lawler and bother him?
Jerry Lawler almost tried to break my neck last year. He made a fool out of me. He humiliated me. He put me in the hospital for 3 days in traction. I had to wear a neck brace for 5 months. He did this to Jimmy Hart, broke his arm, okay? And so you say, I don't have anything better to do. I won't stop. I'm not stopping now. Look, it gives me great pleasure to know that I had something to do with helping to prevent Jerry Lawler from having that world title. And I'll tell you, I'm not going to stop now. I won't stop until I find someone who's going to put Jerry Lawler into the hospital just like he did me. And it won't be for any 3 days. It won't be for a week. It'll be for a month, maybe for a year. Jerry Lawler will not want to go back into professional wrestling when I'm through with him because I'm offering $5,000 to any wrestler that can put him in the hospital. And I'm dead serious about this, ladies and gentlemen. I will not stop until Jerry Lawler's in the hospital.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You just better steer clear of him because I would expect as much out of you.
Who is the smartest manager in professional wrestling? And why am I, like I said, man? Can't you imagine when Lawler saw him over there? He thought he saw Jimmy Hart with a mask on. Then I jumped on the ring. He fainted. Bockwinkel pinned him. Like I said, king, and I use that word loosely. He who laughs last laughs the loudest.
Okay.
King,
King,
Yes.
Try to do something about it, my friend.
Wasn't that beautiful? Wasn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
And you ain't seen nothing yet, baby. You ain't seen nothing yet, baby. Like I said, this is going to be the greatest year for Jimmy Hart he's ever had. Plus, it's already started off the greatest week of my life. Bobby's going to win me that Southern belt. He's got me the Mid-America belt now.
Baby,
it's going to be beautiful.
That Southern belt, I'm going to collect that $5,000 from Andy Kaufman.
Can't you imagine the shock on Lawler's face? He fainted when he saw Hart in me. It's going to be great, Lawler. You ain't seen nothing yet, baby.
Jimmy Hart, beautiful Bobby Eaton. They stand out here, what respect, and then you take a look at what you just saw in there. Well, we've got big action coming up, and you're going to see Brown, Sugar, and Eaton in action in just...
Don't worry, that match is going to take place, baby. I'm fixing to go get Sugar and straighten him out now. Don't worry, the match. We're ready, baby.
Okay, we'll be back in just a moment. Dynamic tag match coming up a little bit earlier. We saw one of those exciting tag teams in the Fabulous Ones, brother. Here is another one. Terry Taylor and the superstar Bill Dundee. And they will be going against the former Southern Tag Champions, beautiful Bobby Eaton and a sweet Brown Sugar. Looks like Hart got everything straightened out with the team, and they're about ready to go in this tag action, Dave.
All right, it's a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match at a total of 448 pounds. From Huntsville, Alabama, Bobby Eaton. From Union City, Tennessee, Sweet Brown Sugar, their manager, Jimmy Hart. And going against them at a total of 429 pounds, from Australia, the superstar, Bill Dundee. From Vero Beach, Florida, Terry Taylor. This match, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee, and Terry Taylor is wearing a Southern Championship belt.
Yes, he is. A fine young wrestler out of Florida, and his partner, a veteran and dynamite competitor, superstar Bill Dundee, going against, regardless of the fact that they do not currently wear belts, I will tell you, one of the better tag teams in all of wrestling, and that's Eaton and Sugar. They're a tough tag team. Oh, thank you, Jimmy. Hart rubbing it in, the fact that Eaton, as we said a little bit earlier, is now the NWA Mid-America Heavyweight Champion, having obtained the belt from Jacques Rougeau, the fine Canadian. Quick one count, not really down enough. Billy was not going for a three count. He was just showing a little dominance over Sweet Brown Sugar. Dundee and Sugar, and there's a tag on Terry Taylor. Talking about a little earlier in our conversation with Hart, I apologize for losing the objectivity. But you know,
I've been out for a month. Is he the only referee we have here? Is Calhoun the only referee here today?
Why? Just a simple answer, Jimmy. Go sit down here. But that's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
You talk to Hart, and I got to be perfectly honest with you. Occasionally, Hart will just get to you, man. There's just no two ways about it.
He will indeed. Many times.
And that is the secret to why the guy is so successful as a manager. He gets to the other wrestler. He gets to the referee. Well, back to this match right here. Terry Taylor, beautiful Bobby Eaton, center of the ring. And Taylor coming in that low crouch, but he's caught by a standing side headlock by Bobby. Shakes him down underneath. And Dundee backs him up, and Taylor clips him. Billy, all he did was intimidate him, and Bobby backed right into Terry Taylor, and Taylor couldn't resist the chance to bust him in a chop.
Dundee says, look behind you, and when he did, there was Terry Taylor. Got the Southern Heavyweight Champ facing the Mid-America Champ in there right now.
That's right. There's the tag again on the superstar, and Billy, beautiful drop kick. Woo, he rang his belt. Cover! But Brown Sugar just reaches in from the outside and pulls Dundee off. There's a tag on Sugar as he is right there to take the tag from beautiful Bobby.
Come on, get that big woman out of there.
Sugar and Eaton against Dundee and Taylor. Monkey flip. Ah. Dundee takes him back into the ropes. A whip. Over the top goes Sugar. Big back drop. And Sweet Brown Sugar is down, only for the count of one. Tag on Terry Taylor. Sunset flip. He got a one. And Bobby Eaton returns a favor to Brown Sugar. And he busts Taylor in the head with that foot.
We've just passed the 3-minute mark of the match. 3 minutes gone.
I'm afraid with the caliber of the teams that we've got in there, this is going to be one of those matches, Dave, when the time limit's up, we're going to say, give us more, about 45 minutes more. Dynamite action between Dundee and Taylor and Eaton and Sugar as Taylor takes one to the midsection. He'll gasp for breath, and Sugar, taking the tag, follows it up, ripping to the stomach. Now he goes to the small of the back. May have been a tactical error. We'll see. He had Terry where he was really ripping that midsection, and Eaton picks up on it and goes right back to it himself. Referee warning Eaton about the use of the fist. Big power slam. Terry Taylor down. His feet are under the rope, so there's no way they're going to get a pin at that point. Yeah, Eaton whips him up, and Taylor was lucky to kick out at that point.
Two count, almost a three count on him.
Hey, give the devil his due. Dynamite power slam from beautiful Bobby Eaton. Brown Sugar takes over. Backbreaker drops him down. Sugar covers him up. Two, and that's all. Jimmy Hart giving the referee a hard way to go about the count being slower than necessary. Sugar runs Taylor into the turnbuckle. There's a tag on beautiful Bobby.
5 minutes gone. That's 10 minutes left to wrestle.
5 minutes gone and 10 to go. And the action continues at that peak level it started out with. Beautiful Bobby dumps Taylor down and goes with the big knee. Ripped right across Terry Taylor, and Taylor has taken some punishment at the hands of Sugar and Eaton. That's not to say that they haven't returned it. Sugar chin locks him and sits down on the spine. But look at Taylor, well-conditioned athlete, Dundee. A friend indeed as he comes in and breaks it up, and Taylor put down by beautiful Bobby Eaton. Dundee hollering with the referee saying, I tagged him, but the ref didn't see it. Hard place for the referee, but look at here! Off the rope! Brown Sugar drop kicks beautiful Bobby Eaton. 2-3, it is over!
A mistake by the family, and Taylor and Dundee wasted no time in capitalizing on it. 5 minutes, 53 seconds of time. 5:53.
They had it all set up. Eaton was holding, and Sugar was pitching. And now Brown Sugar and beautiful Bobby. Little riff in the family. Uh-huh. Eaton and Sugar having a little problem, and Hart trying to be the peacemaker in there. Gets Bobby Eaton back away. Eaton was pinned after the Sugar drop kick, and uh-oh. Now Hart starts to more or less stuff. Sugar grabs a hold of Hart. And the crowd saying, go right ahead. Busting. Beautiful Bobby and Brown Sugar. Had a little riff, in case you just joined us, about a week or 10 days ago. And now Hart is reading the riot act of Brown Sugar. And Hart is sending Sugar back to the dressing room. And the win is going to Taylor and Dundee as Brown Sugar leaves a rather dejected young man, and Jimmy Hart has sent him back to the dressing room after a defeat at the hands of Taylor and Dundee. Jimmy, a little problem in the family, I detect.
I've got everything under control. Let me tell you something. Nobody tries to embarrass me. Bobby, go back in the back and get my shoes, and you get me a cloth. sweet brown sugar, let me tell you something, baby. You better get yourself. You've got 1 minute to get out here and apologize to me. You're going to polish my boots on TV,
Jimmy,
or you're out of the family. You
Jimmy,
understand that? Get my boots.
We don't have
get
to listen
boots,
to it.
Baby.
Let's take a break.
Nobody humiliates
Jimmy,
me, man.
We don't
Nobody.
Want that stuff.
Oh, shut up.
Don't have to start this.
He wants you, so you get out of here.
I'm telling you.
He wants you. What Jimmy Hart wants about it, he's going to get him out of here.
That's
get out of
right.
here.
Get out of here.
Listen, we're not going to put up with this kind of stuff in here, Jimmy. We've got a match coming up with the King, and I don't want to have any of this stuff going on out here.
Sugar, do you hear me in the back? Evidently, you must be deaf. Evidently, you don't realize that your future is on the line right now, baby. I know how to handle this kind. I know how to do it. Now, Sugar, here are my boots. Here is the towel. Now, come on out here. I'm dropping them on the floor, and you've got 45 seconds. 45 seconds to get out here.
Can you imagine?
We're not going to stand around.
Look at this. Look at the man's mouth up here.
All the money that Jimmy Hart has made us.
You've got 30 seconds. 30 seconds.
Yeah, all the money and all you talk about.
Your future is on the line, baby. Your future, man. I've done it all for you. If you better get out here, you're going to go back to riding horses where I found you. I've done everything for him. I'm the one who put him in the outfits he's in and gave him that charisma, man. You were nothing before the family. Now get out here. You've got 10 seconds.
Okay, fine.
5, 3, 2, 1. Okay, baby, you're out of the family. You are out of the family. Like I said, I know how to handle his kind. You are out of the family. You're from now on, you are Coco Ware, right, Bobby? You're a Coco Ware.
That's the first favor that I've seen you do anybody in a long, long time.
I'm the one that has made us, and he wants to ask what's that.
Well, okay.
Here he comes, the King.
Jerry, we had a chance a little bit earlier to show everybody exactly what happened in that situation.
I saw exactly what happened. I know exactly what happened. And you're not, and these people are not the only one to see that film, because let me might add that, you know, it seems that this president of the AWA has been viewing a lot of films lately, and I can assure you that he is going to see that film, and you have not heard the last about the AWA title.
Amen.
Believe me on that. Let me just say this, though. I am sick. I don't even want to say that wimp's name. I am so sick of him. I'm sick of jerks like Andy Kaufman. I'm sick of Bobby Eaton, Sweet Brown Sugar, and the whole stinking family. I'm sick of them coming out here and running their mouths, taking advantage of everybody in sight, and I'm sick and tired of them talking about challenges and bounties, and I just want to say this right now. Hart, I'm going to give you and your whole stinking family your opportunity right now. We don't have to wait. We don't have to wait for any night. We don't have to go down to any Coliseum. I'm going to be right out here. Bring every damn one of your family out here right now. Let's see what you can do about it.
Jerry Lawler's got a match coming up with Sabu, the Wild Man. And here comes Hart. Right behind him is Sabu. And Jerry has just said, bring
man,
the whole
the
family.
The Big King is a little ruffled up, isn't he, baby? Come here.
He's
well, what the King wants, the King.
Come on, Jerry. Jerry. Jerry Lawler, he didn't wait. He hopped out of that ring. He jumped Sabu, slammed him with that chair, banging him around. He's referring, of course, to that $5,000 bounty that Kaufman put up, and he said, I'm not waiting. Bring them all out here, Hart. Get the whole family. We'll take care of them all at one time. Lawler was Sabu. Obviously, this is no match. It's a fight, but oh, man, Lawler. Come on, Jerry. Referee Jerry Calhoun trying to get the chair away from Lawler and get him away from Sabu. Now at least they're up in the ring. Lawler drug him back and threw him in the ring. And Sabu and Lawler are going at it. And here comes beautiful Bobby Eaton. And the King blasts him. Look out, Dave. Eaton down on the floor as Lawler picks up the big chair and slams Eaton. Throws him all the way over the desk and out on the studio floor. Oh, boy. I wouldn't sit down, Dave. Not over with yet. Lawler slams Eaton with that right hand. Look out. Come on, Jerry. Lawler drags Eaton right out, slams him down on the floor, and Sabu has taken a collar off. He nails the King right in the throat, it looked like, with that studded collar that he wears. And now Eaton and Hart have joined in with Sabu. We never did start the match. They've got Lawler tied up in the turnbuckles over here. Jerry needs some help right now. Here comes Bobby Fulton. Good. Referee Jerry Calhoun. Uh-oh, he mild rise Fulton down on the floor. Sabu concentrating on Lawler, and there's Hart. You can believe that. Whitley gets in a situation where he is helpless. Here comes King Cobra out after Bobby Fulton had been pile-drived by Eaton. Eaton picks Cobra up and drops him down. Eddie Marlin. Yeah, Eddie, see if you can get these guys calmed down. They slaughtered Lawler over in a corner. There goes Cobra out of the ring. Eddie Marlin telling Jimmy Hart, you better get your act together and get these guys out of here. Eddie in there with referee Jerry Calhoun. Marlin pulling Sabu off of Lawler, and Hart goes right back at him. Sabu continuing to go after Lawler, and Marlin being pushed away, and Marlin nails Sabu. Bobby Eaton puts up. Get out of there, Hart. Take the family out. Here comes John Sugar back there. Oh, look at here. Sugar going after Eaton. Sugar, who had been the object of the humiliation by Hart. He's just including Sabu along with Eaton. Hart goes running away. Sabu taking a shellacking from Sweet Brown Sugar. Now it's Eaton and Sugar. Here are two guys that have been partners for a long, long time. There's Lawler up. He's got the collar wrapped around his hand that Sabu wears. Eaton hits the deck. Sabu slammed into the ring post. Woo! Well, we always said, Dave, the roughest, toughest wrestling anywhere.
And it's right here.
That was a fight. That's what that was. Sugar came out. He really was after Eaton. And Terry Taylor out to help a little. And Dundee, they've been in a shower, but it's all quieted down. As Brown Sugar really put it on. And whether it was his intention or not, he came to the aid of Lawler. We've finally gotten things settled back down, and Lawler at least is man enough to come over and thank Sugar for the help that he had.
I'm going to tell you something right now. I don't shine shoes for nobody. You know, Jimmy Hart want me to shine his shoes. I'm not shining shoes for nobody. If I have to be in that stinking family, hey, I'm telling you one thing. I'm not shining shoes for nobody. If I have to be in that family, he could take that family and stick it where the sun don't
shine.
Let me just say this. Apparently, Jimmy Hart don't know how to handle his kind. Is that right
That's
or not?
Right. He don't know how to handle my kind.
Okay. We're going to take time out. Dave, I want to go check on Eddie Marlin, and we'll take time out, and I'll be back in a moment.
Busy day.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, what? No stopping now. We got an expiration of time tag team match in store here.
Bobby Fulda and King Cobra coming in. That'll make a doggone good team, too. Cobra's got the bulk. Cobra tipping the scales right close to 240 right now. He is right up there around 238 or something like that. And Fulda, very determined, quick. Youngster out of Columbus, Ohio, coming to the ring now, the Dynasty, with Adrian Street, Jesse Barr, and Miss Linda, accompanied by Jimmy Cornette, and we're ready for the official introductions. Dave?
It'll be an expiration of time match. Team with the most falls to their credit when the time expires will be the winners of the match. Introducing at a total weight of 458 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, the King Cobra, and his partner from Columbus, Ohio, Bobby Fulton, going against him. Total weight of 462 pounds from Portland, Oregon, Jesse Barr. And from the Royal Forest of Dean, England, the exotic Adrian Street. Street with his valet, Miss Linda, with him. And Street and Jesse Barr also have the head of the Dynasty, Jimmy Cornette, over in their corner. Expiration of time match with Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Complete with a mirror to make certain that he is ready for his grandozio action in this expiration time. You're looking at the exotic Adrian Street. That's the most unusual cape, Dave. I don't know whether we've really talked about that much or not. As Adrian, with a flourish, puts it around the hanger. And Miss Linda trying to gather all the paraphernalia together as Adrian gets a little dusting off himself. And now we're about ready to go into action. Expiration of time. Bell time. Street starting out against Bobby Fulton.
Exotic Adrian hanging back in the corner.
This place is a mess. You got to get a woman in here and clean up.
Thanks, Jimmy. Put that under advisement. And exotic Adrian Street skipping around the ring. Bobby Fulton stalking him. Street grabs him. Bobby Fulton, upset. Well, that sort of action. Team after Street. Street. Foot to the midsection, drops him down, working on the leg, steps over on a toe hold. Exotic Adrian Street really putting the pressure on that leg. Thought he might have a submission out of Bobby Fulton, but Fulton did not give it up. Exotic Adrian. Now putting a stretch on that left leg. Upper part of the arm by Exotic Adrian Street. And again, this time across the head, fist to the midsection. Street with Bobby Fulton backed into a corner. And Street over to the corner makes the tag on his partner, Jesse Barr. Jesse Barr fires Fulton into the ropes. Gets a bit of air hug coming off of there. Bolton up in the air. Jesse Barr hanging on to him. Really have put these punishing holes on Bobby Fulton, first streak. He had that leg stretched out there. Now the bear hug by Jesse Barr. Fulton trying to use the right hand to break out of it. But Barr hanging on. Someone in the crowd yelled, pop his ears. Well, that's exactly what he did, and that broke out of the hole. A little cheerleading there on the side, and Bobby gets out of it. Now battling back at Jesse Barr after being in the bear hug for a long time. 2 minutes, 55 seconds gone in this fall. Expiration of time match. Might be one fall, might be three or four. We'll just have to check time as we go. King Cobra in there. Jesse Barr fired into the rope. Backdrop by the Cobra as he comes off the ropes. Over to the corner, the tag made, and Bobby Fulton will be coming back in. Fulton right into the midsection. Still getting even with Jesse Barr after the punishment. He put him in. Jimmy Cornette trips Fulton. Jesse Barr drops down on him. Might be it. One, two, and three. 3 minutes, 32 seconds. The win is going to go to Exotic Adrian Street, Jesse Barr, and Jimmy Cornette.
We're going to check our time and be back in just a moment. All right, back into Channel 3's Championship Wrestling action coming up in just a moment. You'll see them all, seven big matches coming up at Louisville Gardens Tuesday night. You'll want to be there, and if you don't go there for any other reason, I know you're going to have to see that final match when beautiful Bobby Eaton and Sabu the Wild Man with Jimmy Hart at ringside will be going against Jerry the King Lawler and Sweet Brown Sugar.
You know, Lance, we have heard today that this has been the happiest week of Hart's life.
Oh, yeah.
He's up on cloud nine, real happy. Well, let me tell you something, Hart. You better come down off that little cloud of yours and open those beady eyes up and take a look around. Because you see, that family of yours is dwindling, and brother, it's dwindling fast. It's down to only two punks left, Bobby Eaton and Sabu the Wild Man. And after Tuesday night at Louisville Gardens, you may have no family at all. Now, let me tell you something, Hart. I'm sure that in the past, you thought that you could do just about anything you wanted to anybody and get away with it. Well, let me tell you something else. You don't take a man like this right here and slap his face and talk to him the way you did and push him around and get away with it, brother. You just don't do it. Now, a lot of people are sick and tired and fed up with your mess, and I'm one of them, and this man right here is one of them. And Tuesday night, it's going to all come to a screeching halt, brother, because we're going to put a hurting on you and that little stinking family of yours that they won't ever forget. Is that right, Sugar?
You're right, King. I'm going to tell you something, doggone Jimmy Hart. You're nothing but a little old leech. You want me to shine your shoes? I'm not going to shine your shoes, Jimmy Hart. If that's the case, stay in your family. I'm not going to do it. The heck with your family. I guarantee you, Jimmy Hart, you don't go around slapping no kind of human being. You understand that? You don't go around slapping nobody. And I guarantee you, when the King and myself get in that ring, you're going to wish you never, never in your whole life seen me and the King.
Mm.
Let me just say something. This man has made a solemn promise to me. He's not going to change his wrestling style one bit. He's going to wrestle just as hard against Eaton and Sabu as he has against me. And, brother, that's pretty dead gum hard. Hart, the only shoes going to be shined are going to be this man, and you're going to do them Tuesday night, brother.
Boy, I'll tell you one thing. They just beat the bell on that fall right there in order to get it. Our time is about up. How about a recap, David?
All right. In the opening match, it was the Sheepherders defeating Ira Reese and Ken Raper. It was all Sheepherders. 3 minutes, 8 seconds of time on it. Bill Dundee and Terry Taylor got a win. Great teamwork. Very alert. They won it as they defeated Bobby Eaton and Sweet Brown Sugar with Jimmy Hart the time on it. 5 minutes, 53 seconds. A little controversy at the end of that one between Sweet Brown Sugar and Bobby Eaton. Then Jerry Lawler in your schedule against Sabu, that match never got underway. It was no match. It was a battle
was
all over the studio,
yeah,
but no official match there. Then King Cobra and Bobby Fulton taking on the Exotic Adrian Street and Jesse Barr. In this one, Street and Barr favored going in, and they won it. They won the thing rather handily, although they did get quite a battle from Bobby Fulton and King Cobra. Bobby Fulton spent most of the fall in there, but in the end, it was a win for Adrian Street and Jesse Barr.
Yes,
and
sir.
Jimmy Cornette.
We saw the World Heavyweight title match, part of it with Lawler and Bockwinkel, and our time is up. A chink in the armor of the family. We'll keep an eye on it. Till next week, Lance Russell and Dave Brown saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of championship wrestling.